Upstairs in our Canada Games Gallery, we have Krista Hassan. Krista does watercolor, and these particular body of work, they're watercolors on rice paper. And they have very interesting texture, and it was a wonderful technique that she did to create this body of work.
I'm painting on rice paper, which is very, very thin, and it's a different quality and a different surface. The paint sinks into it and goes right through it. Then I use a technique to make it look like it has a lot of lines and a lot of texture. It's similar sort of to batik, if you're familiar with batik, with dyes and fabric and stuff like that. Very similar process, not exactly the same, but it gives you a nice effect. I love the texture and the colors are vibrant. So it's mainly just a technique. I still consider it watercolor. Even with the mixed media, I always use stuff that is water soluble, 100% artist grade. And I just really like the effect I get from it more so than paper. With this, I have a million possibilities in my head. Like, there's a million different things I want to try. I think, ooh, what if I do this? And oh, what if I do that? And I love to experiment. I'm always trying different things. That's how I actually stumbled upon this. I had a roll of rice paper that I actually bought before I even painted because it was on sale. I thought, I'm going to do something with that someday. I didn't know what, but I had it when I was kind of at a transitioning period in my art, and I was really looking for something different, and I wanted something that would express more of me, and I find this really does. I always have a plan, but once I get into the painting, that's where I find the freedom. I'm layering color and layering wax, and once you put that wax on, you really can't see what is underneath, so you're really just kind of trusting your gut. My girlfriends that paint with me on Tuesday night laugh because they're like, what are you doing? Like, how do you know what to put on there? And I just say, I just go with whatever I feel. And luckily they turn out great. Well, I have to say, I love the fall pieces, the trees, bird's eye view, treetop. Those probably are two of my favorites for the landscape scenes, even though they're close up and more intimate, but I just love the color, but I love the lines from the texture. I find there's always something interesting to look at. Like, you can see a little color variance and then a crackly line going through it. I find it draws me, and hopefully it draws other people too. Years ago, when I was in high school, I did batik on fabric in high school art, and I loved it. I loved batik. So for me to find this years later, it was almost like it was made for me. But no, I really like those two, and I love the Laughing Buddha. Don't ask me why, I'm not Buddhist, but I have a thing for Buddhas. I really do. I find them very serene and very peaceful. And I think because I know what they represent, that I'm drawn to them. And there's just, he touches my heart. He makes me almost giggle inside when I look at him. he's probably one of my favorites overall. I think they say you can never go home, but I think we all have those connections from when we were young, those wonderful memories that fuel our emotions. And those were my happiest times as a child, playing in the woods and looking at the fall colors and just being out in nature, butterflies, birds, just always. I always was happy and always had a great time. We would build forts out of trees and climb trees, and just they're the best memories. And I equate those emotions with kind of, I guess, happiness. And I want people to feel that when they look at my paintings. And a lot of people do have that connection with nature. I talk to a lot of people that have that same thing when they were young. I remember when I was young. And it does, it takes them right back to those feelings. And it is, it's emotional. That's the connection with art is very. I'm always kind of looking, not for what I'm going to do next, but for how I can expand and make what I do even better. Because as an artist, you're always learning and you can't be stagnant. You have to always grow. And I find that's what fuels me. I love to experiment. I love to try things. I've tried some pretty silly things, actually. I mean, I'll try anything. And my friends are like, what are you doing to that painting? You're gonna wreck it. I said, well, that's okay if I do, but I'll learn something. And I'm okay with that. I'm not, you know, I know there's room to grow. I know I have to get better. You know, I have people that say, oh, you paint wonderful. Why would you want to change? It's not that I want to change. I want to reach my full potential.